So you guys clicked on today's video, man, to figure out the best way to win this 3v3 pro event, man. The most toxic event ever. Oh, so you decided to play the 3v3 event today. Good shit on round one, man. Let's get it, bro. Round two in the books, too? Okay, I see you. All right, bro, you're going on to round three right now, bro. You have to win this game, man. This is a must win, bro. Yeah, you're gonna be here for a while. Feels good to be back at round three, bro. I'm proud of you, bro. Try to win this game, though, man. Like, you have to win this game. Look at, okay, you got into the game, bro. They're easy. They're literally bombs, okay? Wait a minute. Where are you? What the f-
Till no, till the no, yeah, till the no.
How did you just win that? In the crowd, too? Okay, man, now it's round four, though. Wait, why is the screen white? You know what, just ignore it. Come on, let's get into round four. Okay, there's another white screen for some reason. Don't worry about it. I'm sure there's nothing going on, though. What the fuck? This ain't no crowd, bro. What is going on? Where are you playing at? Is this at a movie theater? What the fuck? Is this the comp curtains? Let me find out. Fuck, man. Them fucking curtains were getting in your way, man. You gotta start all over.
Not at all. No one can stop me. I feel like the greatest. Don't say be humble. I patiently waited. All of this love and I ain't even made it. I got a plan for them niggas that hate it. Run up some bitch for my bros. I'ma make it. They want me going. I can't walk around naked. Even my brother got caught in the 80. No one can stop me. I feel like the greatest. Hop in the foreign. I'm drifting on stupid. Niggas be broke. Like the fuck is you doing? Started off strong, but there's room for improvement. I ain't for nothing. Milwaukee, I'm booming.
What is going on, YouTube? It's your boy Henry, aka Double H. Back at it today with yet another banger, and in today's video, man, I'm gonna be teaching you guys and helping you guys out with the best method to win this 3v3 pro event in NBA 2K19. Now, to start off, this event is so cancer. This shit is gross. It's a very simple event, but what makes it so hard is that there's so many things that get in your way, like lagging out, getting frozen, or just not finding matches, and just a bunch of different things that you need to avoid, and I'm going to tell you how to avoid in this video today. Now, before we get into that, let's talk about the lineup you should run in this event, right? So there's no checkups, so basically, you're going to want to get a lot of threes, though. You don't want to be taking ones. It's twos and ones. So you want to get a lot of twos out there. So you want shooters, and then you want, you know what, at least a decent rebounder, you know, to get those boards. So what I would recommend is some kind of pure glass cleaner, two-way glass cleaner or something, or a sharp rebounder at the three, okay? And then at the two, at the one, I would go with a play sharp, somebody that can dime them up. And at the two, you got to go with a pure stretch, okay? You don't want to run two guards. You got to have a pure stretch. Or if you want, you can run two pure stretches in the glass. But basically, the bottom line is you need a rebounder. And you need at least one shooter, maybe two shooters. And then you could, if you have one shooter, you want somebody that can dime that shooter up and create their own shot. But now that we're done with the lineup, guys, let's get into the rest of the event. So something that you're going to see a lot in this event is the 2K compete screen, right? And if you don't know how to avoid this screen, you're gonna be raging your ass off. You're gonna have a lot of times where you're about to get into the round three game, the round four game, and then you just get 2K compete screen. Now, what is 2K compete screen? It's basically just the screen that says 2K compete, and you get frozen on it, and it never comes back. Like, it never gets out of that screen. So you have to dashboard and then restart to round one. So me and my boys figured out a way to avoid this, and ever since we started doing it, we have never gotten that screen again. And it's not because they actually fixed the screen. Everyone else is getting the screen too. It's because this method actually works. It's very simple too. After every game, right when that 21st point is scored, immediately do not touch anything on your controller. Don't click A, don't look at the stats, don't click anything. Just set your controller down until the next game starts, okay? That's how to never get the 2K compete screen. I don't know why that's the case, but that is the case. So just listen and don't do that, because I know you should just, you basically should just have a teammate right when that 21st point goes in. He should say, don't touch anything, don't touch anything, don't touch anything, whatever. Okay? And that's how you should do it. Anyways, there's going to be two more things that are going to get in your way. And it's going to be playing in the crowd, as you can see on the, my screen, on your screen right there, or playing in the curtains. Now, let's start with the crowd, since you're watching that gameplay right now. As you can see, playing in the crowd is not, it is not comfortable. It is not the same. It is, it's a whole different ball game, okay? So, as you can see, after most rebounds, when the next team gets the ball, there's a red line, and that red line symbolizes the three-point line, obviously. You want to use that to your advantage, because that basically arcs the three-point line. Now, if you could score on this shit like that guy just did, you got to score, man. You also, a big thing is you want to get your shooter to get his grand badge as fast as possible. But then again, you don't want to be forcing up shots. Basically, you just want to be very aware of where you are on the court, even though you can't see where you are, if you know what I mean by that. So let take advantage of that red line, and take advantage when you're inbounding the ball, because when you're inbounding the ball, that's where you're right behind the top of the key of the three-point line. So that should indicate where everything else is on the court. You got to use that to your advantage when it comes to these games, because otherwise, you're going to have a tough time. The people that win these games are the people that have the most experience in these rounds and in these crowds or these glitched courts, basically, okay? It's, and by the way, another thing is, a quick tip for gameplay just in general, don't click Y too early if you're trying to get the rebound, okay? Because you're going to be diving out of bounds every single time. And another gameplay tip, though, before I go on to playing in the curtains, is there's actually a foul method. Just so you guys know, if your team gets the 5 fouls, the other team starts shooting free throws, which is only worth 1. And if you're fouling a glass or a lock, then they're probably going to miss. So just to let you guys know, if you can't stop the 3, then I would just pick up some fouls. But anyways, let's get back into the other thing that can avoid you from winning this event, and that is playing in the curtains. Look at this, guys. You cannot see anything. Now look at this. It's kind of like playing in the what's it called, the crowd, but of course there, you can't see anything once you go inside the three-point line. So once again, when you check that ball on the top of the key, you want to take advantage of that and be aware of what's going on. Now every time I, especially people that aren't used to playing on this or their first time playing on this, they usually just take only shots that they can see. So basically only three-pointers at the top of the key, which is very dumb, okay? You want to take advantage that nobody can see what's going on in the paint. You want to drive to the basket sometimes until, you know, a sharp badge is gained or something, you know, takeover is gained, and then you can shoot threes and stuff, obviously, okay? And if the ball is just sitting still, as you can see right here, look at the ball is just sitting still, do not go after it, okay? Because you're probably going to run out of bounds with the ball. You're going to kick it out or something, and then it's going to be the other team's ball. You have to be very patient when you play in the curtains. You have to play very good defense. Just basically play no threes game, okay? Do not let any threes go in, and you'll be fine, okay? And then on offense, if you have a three, take it. But don't force threes. That's how then your stretch is going to get cold. And then he's not going to be able to make any more shots. He's not going to be close to his badge. You want to get layups, dunks until you get the badge. And then when you get that badge, start shooting that bitch. And if they are really pressing the three, then you can still take ones. And you're probably just going to end up winning the game anyways. Okay? So, once again, man, awareness is very key when you're playing in the curtains. As you can see in this gameplay, man, we were down 9-3. And look at, we just start being patient, we start taking open looks, we start taking ones, and look it, we are right back in it. We just went on an 11-0 run. Want to know why? Because these guys were forcing threes, they weren't taking ones, and guess what, we were taking ones, and then when the three was open, we were taking it. Look at my man D, he doesn't see anything right here, so he's going to kick it out. But look at that, he knows there's only 8 seconds on the shot clock, so he's just going to take the one and be smart about it, even though we have the lead. And then Purchase gets his badge, and now he's shooting lights out. And now these guys are having trouble because they can't guard him one-on-one, and D can just sit under the basket without anybody knowing if they want to go double-team, and basically we're just guaranteed a basket every time after that. And as you could see, after that, we win it finally. We were very excited about that because this event is just so annoying, bro. Now, one last tip for y'all after you win the event, right? You're not the rewards. You gotta. You know, it's a process. Okay. If you want to get your rewards popped up as soon as possible, basically what you're gonna have to do is just dashboard afterwards, and then load into a park, and then join a friend. That is how you get the rewards to pop up, as you can see right here. And then if they don't have the icon still on there, just go to your My Player and see if the shirt pops up, which is exactly what happens right here. But once again, the rewards are the same as King of the Court and doubles. You basically just get a shirt, you get an icon, you get 10,000 VC, 10,000 My Points, and I think times 10 for every skill, for 10 boosts for every category or whatever it is. But anyways, guys, if you guys enjoyed this video at all, or if this helped you at all, make sure you hit that like button, man. And if you're new to the channel, make sure you smash that sub button, man. We are almost at 500 subs right now. I think we're 15 away as I'm making this video, but we need to hit that milestone, and then we're on the road to 1,000. This channel is very underrated, so let's get subscribed before we blow up. You feel me? But anyways, guys, this has been your boy Double H, and I'm out of here. Peace. I was on the ball, I'ma stack that money tall. After I get mine, I'ma share it with my dogs. Gotta carry out the plans, cause you only get one chance. Yeah, I do this for my fam. Haters hate the way I ball. I was on the ball, I'ma stack that money tall.